Yo, what up? Thanks for making y'all weigh in on the grading with another episode, a special edition episode of the Grading Scale. And it's your boys from the Disrespected Collective. And we ain't giving y'all our perspective on no boss we selected because we doing a draft. And it's your boy, Quease, a.k.a. Dash.
And I'm Chris Smith, a.k.a. Sense of Life.
Yeah, I fucked that up, but don't worry about it. It's going to be good. But today we doing a special edition where we doing a draft. So what we going to do is, we got all the greatest artists. We doing the GOAT grading scale. So we going to try to get the best four artists we can think of. And we going to do a bracket type draft. And we going to see who come out with the better artists. And I feel like I'm definitely going to like destroy Craig on this. So it'll be a couple rounds. So like the artists, if they win, they get to the next round. You got to find more bars that can get them past the next artist. So y'all going to be able to see this. And hopefully y'all help us grade. We might need y'all support to help us grade some of these contests out. If it gets a little tight, we might have a tie or something. Y'all need to break the top. But I'm ready for this. All right. So Craig, we got to figure out who's going to get the first pick in the inaugural grading scale draft. How are we going to do this?
I don't know. You can go first because I think that for every artist that you, if you take an artist from off this list that I got, I'll have somebody to replace it. And we only doing, what, four?
We could do eight. We could do 16. We can have an eight on this side and an eight on that side. However you want to do it. Or we can both do four, however you want to do it.
I don't want to do eight.
I got four, you got four.
I'd rather do four. Let's do four.
Yeah. You gonna allow me to go first?
Yeah, because I mean we're probably gonna pick Jay-Z or something. Like who you gonna it's only like three people you could pick first.
Oh, you think so, huh? All right.
Actually, I know who you gonna pick first.
You already know where I'm going. I wish we could do like the little thing where like with the first pick in the inaugural.
I know.
I wouldn't even do it to you.
I wouldn't even took him from you.
Quee selects Fred the Godson. You already know who it is. I'm taking Fred. Fred all the way. Number one seed. Top pick in the bar grading draft is Fred the Godson. Who give you the metaphors? Who give you the real stuff? Who give you the slick talk? Nobody can mess with Fred. Of course I'm going Fred with the number one pick. There's no rapper of all time who give me as much stuff to go from. I could take one song from Fred and win this whole battle. Win the whole thing. All the brackets. No matter who you pick. This is Fred the Godson's battle.
You said ridiculous.
I can do one song. He's the GOAT.
So basically, he's saying that Fred the Godson is the greatest rapper of all time.
And this type of a thing, where we're
rest in peace
bars,
and much respect to Fred.
The legend, Fred is going to be the first pick in the draft. I'm taking Fred the God. Y'all already know.
He'll be in the top 25, though. I'll put him in
top 20. Only way Fred don't win this is if Craig try to be on some haters. That's why we're going to need y'all to help. We ain't going to lead us up to Craig to hate on the bars we going to do, because I know you're going to be on some hater stuff. First pick in the draft, right. Fred the Godson.
Fred the Godson. Let's see. I don't want to. Who do I? Oh man. You know what? Cheat codes, huh? You know what? I'm going there. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm doing that. I guess if you gonna choose him, we going with cheat codes. I'm using Drake.
Oh, I didn't think you would do that.
I mean, who else gonna combat with them bars though? Who else gonna have?
That was gonna be my second pick.
Who else gonna have shit that's gonna go back and forth? You know what I'm saying with
you
them?
Just messed up my whole.
Yeah, man.
I didn't think you would pick.
See, sometimes you be like, "Yeah, pick first." Sometimes picking second and being on defense is the best thing.
I ain't gonna even hold you. That just kind of threw a wrench in my. Oh God, that ain't where I thought you was gonna go.
I know you didn't think I was gonna go there. But
we need an intermission. Intermission now. Took Drake from me.
I got like 10 artists here, so I got some. I'm gonna find somebody off this list, and this artist that I didn't even put on here. Like I ain't got Scarface on here. It's a few people I ain't got on here. I ain't even got Tupac or Biggie on here.
I'm shocked you took Drake. That messed up my whole. Cause now I gotta figure out. I don't know what you might have for my third artist.
Yeah, pick 21. He relevant.
All right. With the number two pick, or with the number three pick at this point, in the inaugural grading scale draft, You had the second pick. You took Drake.
But this is second round.
Yeah, but
no. Oh, you right. Pick. You had
the
second pick. No,
but the third pick.
All right. I guess it is a Drake. Like,
Quee selects Jada Kiss.
Okay.
I'm going to take Jada. I'm going to take Jada.
That's cool.
I feel like I can definitely get enough work That's from cool. Jada to get me through a couple of good rounds. Jada's going to be... I think my artist is going to win every round. You're going to end up having to pick bars from my artist.
Oh, wow.
That's what's going to end up happening. I think I'm going to sweep you the first round. I don't know. You had Drake, though.
Of course. That's what's crazy.
But we're going to go with Jada.
Jada. Now, I should pick his brother in rhyme over there. Because I got him on this list over here. If y'all don't know, then, you know, he got a joint album with him. Y'all should go check it out. Freddie and Jason. If you going Jada, man, I'm going to have to go deep and I'm going to have to dig. But if you going Jada and I don't want to go with his brother, I'm going to just go Joe Budden.
This dude is literally taking people that I was going to
have. Bruh.
Oh, I didn't think you was going to go Joe that early in the draft.
Look.
Yo, you messing up.
Why do you not think that I know these? I know Joe got bars and shit. And if I'm gonna need somebody to go with Jada Kiss, and I don't think this would be the exact lineup, but I'm just saying, if you got this person,
not necessarily mean he's the matchup.
Yeah, if you got this person on your team, then I need somebody to guard that player if they do a 4-on-4, 5-on-5. Who gonna guard Jada? Who gonna guard Fred the Godson? Drake. Who gonna guard Jada?
See, the fact that those your first two artists, now I'm like having second and third thoughts on my next draft picks. Cause we got the mindset on the same.
If you wanna switch it, we can too to make it even. I can go first these next two, and then you can rebuttal to my two picks.
Okay. Okay. All right. I'll let that rock. We'll do the snake draft for the last two rounds. All
right. You know that's only these the last two, so it's only
yeah.
I didn't right. Okay. I just never heard of whatever you just said. Snake draft. I don't know.
Yeah, you don't do anything sports related, Greg.
I don't know what the
draft.
I'm like, what is that?
Order comes around and goes back around. So the person who picked last picked first the next round.
I never heard of that before.
This dude, we got to get into sports.
Bro. Oh man! All right. Just two more. Ooh. I will have a lot of new stuff to pick from if I chose this guy. I want to kind of stick to one of the younger guys, but I ain't going to lie. They don't really be having bars like that if I'm looking over there at these two in the red. This one, though, I'm sure I could find some stuff. And I'm going to have to go with him. I'm going Nas. I'm going to do Nas. I feel like that's a little bit of the cheat code because I've been listening to the new album and he got a lot of new stuff to pull from. But it's still Nas, though, because I still can go back to Illmatic and all of that, too. So,
okay.
I'm going to go Nas.
That's a good solid pick. I think what I'm going to do with the sixth pick in the draft, I'm going to take someone that I thought would have been off the board already, but he's still there. And I even gave you a chance to pick him this round, yet he's still there. And I think it's only right I make this pick. I'm taking Kendrick Lamar.
Okay. All right.
Kendrick Lamar. More than enough things in this catalog to get me through multiple rounds.
It is.
With K-Dot.
With Kendrick.
I'm going to take K-Dot.
I hesitated. I thought about picking him, but I hesitated because I was like, as much as I like Kendrick,
It's just bar.
I didn't think you'd do that because you don't really rock with Kendrick. Yeah.
I'm not a hater. He nice. I'm not a hater.
But all right. And y'all can't be choosing. These still gonna be bars like chosen off whatever. Don't be picking it because y'all know who it is and being like, nah, I'm choosing that because that's a Kendrick bar. Y'all know Nas will clean him up real quick.
Hey, listen, don't try to put the he already's trying to start. See, this is what Craig be trying to do. He already trying to shift y'all judgment on the rounds before they even happen because he already know I can find hella shit in that catalog. So he already trying to put it in y'all ear like, don't just try to pick it.
I got
to
do some listening. I ain't going to lie. I ain't heard Joe Budden in a minute music-wise. I ain't really played a project from him.
I'm going to get Joey up out of there, either one of them three artists. I'm going to get him up out of there.
don't know. It's gonna be hard because you know Joe Budden music too, so I gotta find some. I'm gonna go all features. Every track he did with Sue Surf, that's what I'm doing. Whatever he played. He played one recently on the podcast. It was fire. As a sleeper. This last one, this is who I thought you was gonna pick on some just to like fuck with me. And you end up picking Kendrick, so I'm happy.
Oh, you can take him. I know who you finna pick. I know who you pick. Take him.
You don't know who I'm picking.
That's why I took Kendrick. Take him.
You don't know
I'm
who I'm
body
picking
him with Kendrick. Take him.
Oh, nah. You don't know who I'm picking there.
Take
you wouldn't
him.
Say that.
Bodying him with Kendrick.
All right. Well, you're going to have to get somebody to deal with. Me. I'm choosing me. I told you I'm getting in it. I'm putting my lyrics in there. I'm putting my bars in there. I want to compete with these niggas. Since Their Life is who I'm choosing is my last choice. Y'all lucky I didn't make them number one, but I had to.
I had to
battle. I can't have Fred and Drake on the same scene.
Hey, it always got to be a bust in every draft.
You know? Hey, dude. I'm a clean up whoever. I'm picking me for real too. And I'm a clean up. I'm a win one round. Watch. I might not win everything.
That's because you're gonna try to cheat.
I'm gonna win one round.
He gonna try to cheat. I know he gonna try to cheat because it's him.
I'm gonna judge it very fairly.
No, because you're gonna be like, well, that ain't better than my bar. I know you. You have a history of doing
this. Well, if you put me up against somebody like Fred the Godson, then of course I'm not gonna be able to win.
That's why we gonna need y'all help, because he's gonna definitely cheat in the Sincere Life bracket.
But
I guess you
ain't fucking with my wins, brother Bar. You ain't even heard that yet.
I ought to pick.
If you did, you don't remember.
I ought to pick myself just to make this fair. I should pick myself, but I ain't gonna even do that. Cause I'm gonna stay within the true culture of the game.
I'm hip hop.
And look, we gonna put the bracket up of Kendrick Lamar versus Sincere Life. Who the hell is Sincere Life?
And that's exactly why. That's exactly why.
You might go viral.
Go find out who it is. And I got a song with Kendrick Lamar that I made, that I put myself on with Kendrick Lamar. But when I put it out, at least two people was like, "Hey, you kind of cleaned them up on that."
Oh,
so that's two people.
You trying to go against Kendrick? In my bracket?
Come on, man. Just pick who you was going to pick. Why we got to do all this other crazy stuff?
You already know who I'm picking. Since Craig didn't take him, I'm definitely going to take him. Because I'm a Michigan nigga. I'm taking Eminem. Actually, no. Scratch Eminem. I don't want him.
Who?
I don't want him.
Cause I was gonna let you have him.
I want Royce.
I was gonna say, you don't need.
Give me Royce.
You don't
actually
like
no.
Him.
I don't want Royce. I don't want Royce. Cause I feel like
trick man. Look at what's dude name? Esham.
Look, Dayton family nigga. Nah, I don't even want Royce. I don't feel like it's fair. I don't feel like having M or Royce is going to be fair, because they're going to wipe the floor with Sincere Life, right? So I want to keep this fair. I want to give Sincere Life a chance to compete. Ready for this?
Eminem probably won't smoke, but
Eminem definitely won't smoke.
Royce probably won't smoke too.
But I got another article. You ready for this thing? And whenever you ready for Sincere Life, this is going to be waiting for him. You ready? I'm taking Crooked Eye. I'm going to wipe you. I'm going to get him up out of here. Crooked Eye, Jadakiss, Fred the Godson, and Kendrick Lamar. We wiping the floor with whatever four artists you got. That's what we doing.
That's a good four. And I'm definitely the bench player on my team, but that don't mean that I might not come in and score a miracle bucket, though. So don't be acting like...
I know you got some bars.
Don't
I'm not
be acting like I might not come in and hit a clutch three and then get right back out the game.
Hold on. I'm going to tell how I know I'm finna wipe the floor with him, right? Because Craig going to make sure he try his hardest to get that round that he using his bars in, that he going to slack on the other rounds. And I'm going to get all of them the fuck up out of there. I know you. You going to make sure you might write some new shit to make sure you got the hardest
first
bars
of all,
to think of.
Drake is the cheat code. Just Fred is the cheat code because he got so much. Yeah, Drake got the metaphors and the bars. He just... If he not the best, he is definitely in the top three at that category, that statistic, that 2K slider in rap. He's in the top three of that. Drake, though, has about 18 writers, so he could come up with a bunch of great stuff.
Drake is a cheat code. That's why it's gonna be my number two pick. I ain't even gonna hold you. Drake was definitely the number two pick.
You know, Joey is slept on. A lot of people don't. Yeah, but a lot of people don't know. And then Nas, I'm going with because I need a legend. I need a legend. And then with me, I got confidence in myself, and I think that I could at least hold some type of measure. I don't think I'm finna get a bunch of Fs. I tell you that much.
Nah, you ain't got no Fs. You're not a whack rapper.
I think that I'm gonna win at least a round, and if I win the round and I can be in the realm of these, then I think I'm good. Plus, I didn't want to Fabulous. I would have chose him. Gucci Mane, I would have chose. If you would have chose somebody trap, that was my trap artist in the tuck. I would have chose Sci-Hi, but we already did him.
We already
used his bar, so I feel like I'm gonna have to go through his stuff again and
find
more different.
Yeah, because we already had used Pat.
And Jay-Z is just, I don't know, man. Everybody think he the GOAT already. He great, so I feel like that have been not a cheat code, but it's just.
Here's the thing about Hov. I thought about Hov, but the thing is, I feel like some of Hov's slickest bars, the average person ain't even gonna catch. And if I give you some of Hov's slickest bars and go over your head, I'm gonna get a bad grade. People listening gonna give it a bad grade because you ain't even catching it. Most of Hov's best
but
bars.
You could have damn near did a whole five rounds off of the God Did First, though, alone.
I mean, I could, but then you know who the artist is. It just got weird. I ain't take Hov for that.
I got you.
I feel like Hov definitely got enough where I could have definitely got me a bunch of A bars out of there, but yeah. Some of Hov's stuff is kind of intricate, where it's kind of like Nas. Nas got the kind of bars that's dope as shit, but it's more so in a certain format. That's why I stayed away from Nas. And you listening to it in the track, you're like, yo, that shit's nice. Like in the new joint, the King Disease 3, Nas getting off.
You heard it?
Oh, yeah. I heard it now, yeah. Nas is getting off. But, you know what I'm saying? I never said I didn't like it.
That's why I say,
don't make it like I'm hating it because I like Nas. Like, I'm a Nas fan.
Oh, man.
But I'm older, so that was the whole point. Like, you know, whatever. But I had Jada in the tuck because I feel like I know I'm going to get mad punchlines, the real stuff. I had Jada in the tuck.
I feel ashamed a little bit because I didn't even write Jada down.
Oh, you slipped.
I didn't even write Jada down.
I had Jada
if in I was, tuck. If I'm being real with you, that was one when you said it, I was in my mind like, fuck. I'm a fucking nigga, Jada Kiss. Four bar king. He taught me how to rap in four bars. Word. Like, Jada Kiss taught me that. Listening to Jada taught me, oh, I just do this four times and I got a verse. You know? You do this 12 times, you got a song.
Punchline, one of the punchline kings with the four bar setups.
So, yeah.
Man, that's what Jada do. Yeah. So I'm like, okay, I know I can get some fire shit out of Jada. And then I had Kendrick in the tuck just in case. You took somebody lyrical and you got somebody like Nas. Okay, I'm going to take a Kendrick. I knew Nas was coming at some point. I got to have somebody like Kendrick that I can go into different bags and get different type of lyrics. And then I had, of course, the GOAT Fred. Of course, we got to have the GOAT Fred.
I already knew that was going to be your first choice.
That was going to be my first
choice. I wouldn't even if I would have had first choice, just on some perception and fairness, and I wouldn't have chose Fred because now I got to go scramble and listen to him. When you probably damn near already know all the best bars. I know how dope he is, but I ain't heard all this music like you probably heard all of it.
I heard that and everything.
Yeah.
But like Crooked Eye was a person I had in the tuck, and I'm like, just in case he take M and Royce, I'm going to take Crooked. But the more I thought about it, I said, you know what? Because I know he going to come with some shit with his little Sincere Life draft pick. If it's one person who I know going to give me enough metaphors, similes, punchlines, all that, the syllable, like, you know, Craig like rhyming all them syllables. If it's anybody going to give me that, Crooked is going to give me that, and I'm going to wash them.
I ain't going to lie. When you said that, I was thinking and looking at, like, damn, who on that list do I think I really could, like, beat easily? And it ain't really nobody easily. And even Crooked Eyes, like, damn,
monster.
It's like I gotta bring out all my best of best stuff before I, like, if I'm gonna be fuck, because Crooked ain't no,
Crooked ain't no joke.
We should make Crooked go against Joe, though. But anyway, have it
that
go.
That would kind of we might be able to do that. That might look good in the algorithm. But that's been another episode of a special edition of this thing we do called a grading scale. Y'all just witnessed the draft, and we'll get back at y'all next week, and we'll start the brackets, and we'll see who we got up first. I feel like I might sweep the whole thing. We might not even get to the finals. Look, I might just sweep the whole bracket.
It ain't gonna be no sweeps. Even if it's all yours, your artist, then I'm gonna just find songs from them and play the other half. So.
Yeah, as long as I get Fred. He can't have Fred no matter what. All the way to the top.
Yeah, nah. That's fine. You can have Fred. That's cool. It's gonna be Sense of Life of Fred at the end.
Ooh. Spoiler. Ain't no damn spoiler. All right, y'all. We out, man. We'll see y'all next week for another episode. And it's been your boy, Queese, a.k.a. Dash, my man.
Craig Smith, a.k.a. Sense of Life.
And we out. Thistle.